Come all ye jolly ploughmen, with courage stout and bold, for labour all the winter, through stormy winds and cold, to clove your fields with plenty, your farmyards to renew, to crown them with content. Remains the painful plough. Now Adam was a ploughman, when ploughing first begun, and the next that did succeed him was Cain, his eldest son. Some of their generation their calling doth pursue, the bread may not be wanted, remains the painful plough. No ploughman, says the gardener, don't count your trade with ours, for there's walking in the garden to view those early flowers. There's all those curious borders and pleasant walks to view. There's no such peace and contentment provided by the plough. No gardener, says the ploughman, our calling don't despise. Every man for his living doth on his trade relies. For were it not for the ploughman, both rich and poor must rule, for we are all depending upon the painful plough. Now behold the wealthy merchant that sail upon the seas, that bring the golden treasures to those at liberties, that bring those fruits and spices and silks to all souls. They are brought from the Indies by virtue of the plough. And the men that do bring them, we've only to be true. Well, they could not sail on the ocean without the painful plough, for they must have bread, biscuits, flour pudding, beef and peas, to feed the jolly sailors as they sail upon the seas. And I hope that no one's offended with me for singing this, for I never was intended for anything amiss. If you consider it rightly, you'll find that what I say is true. There's not a man that you can mention can live without the plough, the painful plough.